Yeah, I know, already.
So I'm a happy person, but I'm not going to laugh because
right.
You're my serious musician. I play classical music. But we can go now. South Carolina, South America, South Korea.
South Africa.
We're going to South Africa.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh yeah, I'm so sorry. I cannot hear myself very well. Yeah, I'm sorry. I cannot hear myself at all. Yes, we are officially starting this tour today. It's Sunday, October 5th. No, I'm sorry. Not at all. It's Monday, October 10th. The 9th? Oh yes, October 9th. I'm so sorry.
Hello. Well, the band just broke, so so let's begin the tour again now that we have the right car.
So that's a special thing.
Yeah. So hopefully in the Netherlands, people are going to be enjoying what we do.
Yeah.
Not throwing tomatoes to us.
And, I'm sure they won't.
And if they do, well, they're going to be well received.
You throw some back. It's eclectic music.
Yeah, it's a YouTube-made music.
So when you're in you, whether you're in France or in New York, it's just a part of you.
I think it's a problem that we cannot get rid of.
That's a nice.
That's very honest, by the way.
Yeah. He's being very honest. We're gonna listen to you. Two pieces, Arbolitos, the piece for your mother.
Yeah.
Yes. We're gonna play Arbolitos. Yes. Yes, it's a piece related to the inner child we all leave behind at some point.
It's a very grateful instrument. Or, but you can also vibrate like a violin.
Yes.
We're going nowhere at all. The lowest country in the world, Netherlands.
So, what do you think of Utrecht?
It's the city in the Netherlands. The city.
Fernando, ben je er klaar voor?
La vista gorda.
A brochure with instructions on how to cross properly this legendary street, Abbey Road, in order to get to the studio, Abbey Road. It doesn't matter if you're coming here as a tourist or you need to make music in the studio, recording, engineer, whatever, playing piano. It's a fact that you need to cross the street in order to go to the studio, and it's going to be in the opposite direction, which is against the Beatles, which I hope is not going to be a curse for my future project. So I invite you guys to cross the street with me. No, it's a complete failure. I couldn't cross the street because of the traffic, and I also got a curse from someone, a driver, who thought I was intending to cross the street, but in a couple of minutes we'll do it. I'm gonna be late anyway to the studio.
Muchas gracias. ¿Te acordás? Mi longuita vos eras la pebeta más linda de Chiclana, la pollera cortona y las trenzas, y en las trenzas un beso de sol, y en aquellas noches de verano que soñaba tu almita mujer, al oír en la esquina algún tango chamullarte bajito de amor, estercita, hoy te llaman mi longuita, flor de noche y de placer, flor de lujo y cabaret, mi longuita. Los hombres te han hecho mal y hoy darías toda tu alma por vestirte de percal. Cuando sales en la madrugada, milonguita de aquel cabaret, toda tu alma temblando de frío, dice, ay, si pudiera querer. Y entre el vino y el último tango, pa'l cotorro te saca un bacán, ay, qué bien, milonguita te sientes. Y si lloras, dicen que es el champán, estercita, hoy te llaman milonguita, flor de noche y de placer, flor de lujo y cabaret, milonguita. Los hombres te han hecho mal y hoy darías toda tu alma por vestirte de percal.
Connection between Fernando Otero and Julian Labro has taken form in their collaboration under the name of Chat. The album contains compositions by both musicians, in which improvisation plays a major role, exploring counter melodies with their respective instruments, creating a solid soundscape. Otero and Labro complete each other's thoughts throughout Chat. Building up exciting textures and piercing melodies. Their symbiosis is evident from the very first conversational interplay between bando, neon, and piano that drives the listener into a wide variety of colors and emotions. Grammy winner and Warner Music recording artist Fernando Otero is considered by critics as a composer who has created his own style, using elements of classical contemporary music and improvisational jazz, based on the tango as a primary language. He's also regarded as a virtuoso pianist, classically trained. He found his voice as writer-musician when, at the urging of one of his music teachers, he began to incorporate the sounds of his native Buenos Aires into his work. Otero has written music for orchestra, chamber ensemble, string quartet, choir, and solo instruments as piano, violin, and cello, has recorded 12 studio albums, and is currently performing his repertoire for piano and orchestra. In his recent album, From This Point Forward, Julian Labro talks about the music of Fernando Otero. Jazz, contemporary classical, or tango are genre labels far too cramped to encapsulate the music from the Argentine composer and pianist, whose composition, From This Point Forward, is featured on the record. Breathless fugues, opaque chord clusters, and circular grooves here have a tincture of tango, but the language has evolved into something much more risky. French-born Julian Labro has established himself as one of the foremost accordion and bandoneon players in both the classical and jazz worlds. His artistry, virtuosity, and creativity as a musician, composer, and arranger have earned him international acclaim and continue to astonish audiences worldwide. After graduating from the Marseille Conservatory of Music, Julian began winning international awards, taking first prize in the Coupe Mondiale and the Castle Fédéral competitions. After sweeping first place in the Marcel Azzola, Joe Privat, and Medard Ferraro competitions, Labro moved to the United States to further pursue his studies and musical dream. Otero and Labro recorded 2 hours of music in a warm and relaxed environment in New York City, in a playful mood. Apparently both with the feeling of meeting an old friend after a long time. Searches for new themes and untried concepts, transforming and developing his creative ideas into new projects. Being Piazzolla a major influence, and the reason why he picked up the bandoneon. Strongly lyrical as solo performers, Labro and Otero merge into a full and interactive musical speech, alternating rhythmical and melodic protagonism, and quickly exchanging leading roles. The album probably derives its name from the word chat, which in French means cat, the way these two musicians call each other in their multilingual conversations. Perhaps it's only a definition of their musical dialogue, the way these two artists face their work together, as an instrumental conversation. violinist and composer Fernando Otero and cellist and composer Adam Fisher have just put the finishing touches on their new album, Explosion. Their first recording as a duo, Explosion feeds off the energy of New York City, imaginatively blended with the lyricism of Otero's native Argentina. Music recording artist Fernando Otero is recognized by music critics as a virtuoso pianist and also as a composer who's developed his own style with elements of classical contemporary music and improvisational jazz while using the tango as a starting point. Composer Adam Fisher is a seasoned virtuoso with an imaginative flair for improvisation. His widely deft playing makes the cello sound alternately deeply human or startlingly alien, mixed together with a wry sense of humor. Fisher does things with and to the cello few can and fewer would dare. Broad emotional spectrum ranges from dreamy, almost impressionistic melodies to rhythmic avalanches of sound. The duo can sound like a wild, almost unhinged orchestra one moment, then suddenly shift to a shockingly quiet, intimate dialogue the next. Fisher kick off their Explosion tour this fall with concerts in New York City, to be followed by appearances throughout Europe in spring of 2015. Individually charismatic as solo performers, together Fisher and Otero are more wild orchestra than duo. Otero's piano often playing the role of percussion section to the vocal swoops and guitar strums of Fisher's cello. In Explosion, Otero and Fisher redefine the possibilities of cello and piano in a way that will appeal both to fans of traditional classical music looking for something new, as well as listeners who come from jazz, tango, or even rock, who will find familiar elements from these styles fused into something at once intense and enjoyable melodic.
Thank you. Muchísimas gracias.
Maybe if you ask me to define God or love, I'm going to be much more short. No, but I heard many times from Swamis, gurus, it's all about mitigating pain. Even if it's the person who's making music or the audience. It's not about the style. I think it's about the process to access a higher level of consciousness. Broadening the sky. If the sky is bigger, then even if there's a few clouds there, the sunlight is still visible. The connection to a state of, let's say, contemplation, meditation. I also understand that music brings connection between human beings. There's going to be a bigger connection between them when sharing music. A good way to connect without points of view. There's no points of view to defend.
Thank you.